problem of me Colonial Courtyard and have faces for different streets. This is the kind of blocks that are made the Madrid and Barcelona, the extensions of Madrid and Barcelona are made from. With our architectural tools, we try to break these blocks. You see, you have these chambers, and we try to avoid the images the plan have for this building. So we made some operations. We sliced our plot. It's only this quarter of our plot. It's the whole block, and our plot is in this quarter. So we slice it. Then we slide between the pieces we obtain, and then we put voids between the buildings. Not real voids, but make put some more transparent open volumes, or between the more closed or opaque volumes. And this is the result of this operation, the result of the perspective of this operation.
Now, like a new owner, you have to imagine the very first contact with your new house. So you are right here, and then you realize you are in between the both world, the small town and the suburb, the big block world. So this is the first connection you have visually with the building. It doesn't work. So we arrived with the tower car because somebody told us you have to arrive with a car. You don't know yet, you can arrive also walking because the underground is very close to the plot. But they arrived with the car. And we are going to present the character. Here are our owner, she's Betty Sanchez, she's Luke Freddy. This is Don Garcia, he's fine looking, as you can see. And they are going inside the house for the very first time. They go by car, so they have to arrive to the garden. So this is the first visual connection with the inside the building. And they start to wonder something about this place, asking some questions to themselves, like, oh, this is a dark garage with dark ceiling, but there are visual connections between the different plants. And also, because the ceiling is dark, the facilities the facilities you can read. So they found the parking place, the 41, and that's what happened.
So what we tried to do was actually to maintain this what you develop this permeability between the transparency and connections between the street, which is here, and the courtyard. And that was one quite important thing because that's a way to keep the street alive if you have people there. So this entrance and the entrance of the cars is the only good street. And when you thought about the garage, well, it's our first work, so we wanted to make it really, really nice. So we also tried to make it as good as possible. And to make it, we made these split levels, which give quite very much transparency. So from one side to the other, you always can see the exit, and you always can see the natural light coming from the entrance, even from the other side of the garage. Well, not from the second floor, but the side of the garage. So we try to make it feel in some way as a cute. And as we know, it's for the people who are living here, this will be mainly, sometimes, the main interest of the building. So it's also a place to take care of. But, of course, we made much more work on the ground floor. And one of the things we also tried to do was to raise, as you can see here,
The ground floor is 1 meter above the ground level, so the flooring situation on the ground floor are 1 meter above the street level to protect the privacy.
So let's continue with our garden. There are some questions. We would like it. I don't know, little Tony. Maybe. So after a little while, this building is not just for this couple, it's for all the neighbors. So here we have the neighbors and warning you like the gypsies again. So there are the neighbors. They go to the first contact with the building is in the patio, in the town yard. And it's a little bit strange, this patio. It seems like the moon surface. It's like, maybe we can make a moon water there. There are some glass facade, some white facade. It's a bit strange.
Well, this is the ground floor. The cross section we've seen before was this way. It was the ramp, this is the street, this is the courtyard. We have facing the street, we have those big flower pots that are filled there are some plant trees to soften the contact with the building with the pavement, and also because of the reddish leaf, the plants we have contrast nicely with the black and white of the facade. In the courtyard, we divided it into areas, a covered one for the distribution to the access, vertical access court, four access court that bring us to the different or the different houses, different flats. And a zone here for children to play and for the neighbors to gather and to like a more static place. We treated this place. We treated it as in a more organic way. The geometry is more close, like for that of the nature. We want a contrast between the building, the geometry, the rigid geometry and square geometry of the building, and the curves of the nature. We also put some three elements that we wanted to, what two elements, more that we thought it was very important. A winding bend for people, concave and convex, for people to gather, and for people like to be alone, read, whatever, we can decide, because as I told you, this is facing south, this corner, so it's going to be really fun. And three trees that we thought of them to be huge trees for giving shadow for this place, but in the budget they become quite open side trees. So what we made is put in a lot of earth that we saw in the cross section for the trees to grow bigger and give a nice shadow. The placing of the bench is not. It's not casual. It's put in that place because it's close to the entrance, and it's going to permit that the neighbors meet in that place. They have to pass to that point, and they will have to say hello, and that will, I think, will improve the social relationship between neighbors.
Here we can see the first connection between the different neighbors. As they have to arrive to this patio to go to the different houses, they can meet together in this place. It's a common place. So right now, do you see that there are our characters there? We continue with the story. One thing interesting in Spain is our characters, they have grandfathers, fathers, and the fathers and the grandfathers, they come from the village outside my Madrid. And those villages, it is typical to spend the sunset taking out the chairs of the houses in the street. And that is something interesting we call La Fresca, because this is a social situation where all the neighbors, they have a social place in the street, in the common place.
Actually, it gets hot inside the house, and it's better to be outside with the room closed, and it gets fresh air. And a side effect of that is that it increases social relations. And we wanted to take that, that whole thing that was happening in villages in Spain to this new building and to mix these two things together. As we got to do. That was one of the starting points.
So that's how it's working in our building. There are places in the common space to try to do this kind of fresca in our club. So there is a place where you can relax, where you can socialize, but it's a place also where you can work if you want. Yes, self. We are in crisis, so and here is our character, Don, and there is Betty. Betty is asking him to say something from the patio, and we are going to explain how it works, this relation between them.
We also wanted to take special care of this access course. Usually in Spain, what you see social houses is this closed stairs with a fire exit door and a closed fire. And we didn't want to do that. It was the first project, so we wanted to make it so really open and also with the elevator on the other side. So we always enable, so that's actually what we were meant. You always pick outside, you have this light from outside. And that also when you walk the stairs, you also always be walking. And these balconies, they are like falling over the courtyard. So there's quite a lot of insulation in the place. And not for people, but sometimes it's easier and it's more fun to go to the stairs when you're open and just look at the
Dave Fanare found the stairs in the new house. They want to visit there. Let's go home. So we are going to follow our characters inside the house.
Well, that was, we see the entrance of the house. We kind of like to give it to sign the entrance, not to make it like anonym on the door, like we put a different color to its its floor. Its door has its a different color, so you know your home by the color. So, and also it's sheltered by this this brand. So that's why. Well, this is the unit the type unit land, and this is the.
The photo was taken.
Yes, in this way we have the one of the important concepts of this building is this contrast between the a closed body and an open one. We call it exposed and private. This is the concept of exposed. People can see you from the street, people can see you from the courtyard, people can see you from other houses, because it's the place of the living room where we think inside the privacy of a home, the living room is the part, like the more public part. And we thought that this could increase like the relationship with this will make the street like more vivid and the inner courtyard also make it more livable, more like there will be more things happening. And this is the opposite. This is the private area where the bedrooms are. Bedrooms are a place where you want to like to sleep, or when you want some more privacy. That in the we can see the walls are thicker to increase this sensation of the of privacy and of distance with the world, with the outside world. That's why we put the building cupboards in the perimeter to make the walls even thicker. And then there's the other zone, which is the exposed one. The result is this strip scan of open volumes and closed ones.
Somewhere you can see that it resembles the, or we're trying to make it resemble the opposite at the same time. It's an idea from the inside and also from the outside, working together. And, well, we do a lot of work also in the design of these windows. We have these very big ones, which we'll get to later, and we have these other ones in the private area. Those were designed to be as minimal as possible, just flat, no frame. So, and that was possible designing the concept. We had the construction, this is the masonry in the facade, and we have this edit, which is it's the insulation on the outside, which is a new system staying on here. Here it's been used by 5-6 years. I have for 30 years in other parts of Europe, I don't know. And that permits us to hide the frame of the window. So we get this minimal window which you have seen before. So soon we'll get back to the government.
Yes, regulation is all about, again, the unit plan. The basic system states that the measured size of each part of the devoted to each part of the housing program, the bedrooms, bathrooms, and living rooms are fixed. So and they are fixed, and also they are difficult like to combine because they are not modular. They are not they don't fix appropriately. So one of the things we made to improve the regulations, go farther from the like just the city to build the regulation was to extend. We were asked to put by regulations to put a linear circle, the diameter circle, and we decided to put the in that space, include the space of the kitchen, so to have a wider space in the living room, a big public space of the house, in contrast with the little bedrooms that are strictly the ones that the regulations tell us to use. This is another very important concept of the house was these two sliding doors, the sliding doors from floor to ceiling, that they don't leave any frame in the corner, so that they give them a bigger sensation of continuity between interior and exterior, and also improve the sensation of making the room bigger. This is why we're doing it.
When our character dog, they apply for the apartment, he didn't know the apartment will have a terrace or not. Maybe the apartment has a balcony, maybe not. Maybe it doesn't have anything. So it's very vital for them to understand they have a... It's not a real terrace, but it looks like a terrace because as you can open completely the corner, you feel like you are a little bit in the outside.
That's where the idea came from. That is what happened in social housing, usually, is that, at least in Hamburg, that the flats are so small that you have to take these terraces and do it inside. And so we thought that if that's what's going to happen, let's do it from the beginning. And let's make these windows, which we showed one horrible, let's make them as good as we can. So, and that was supposed to be the main length of the project, and which we had to struggle very hard to, like, not to use it through all the projects, because it's quite expensive, and you have to be very stubborn to get it. And we are quite happy. Actually, not only is it on the constructor thought they were too big. Also, people in the social house in the NAU, they also thought they were too big. And they also saying we should make it smaller. But we thought we should not. We should be more. Just for people to be able to do that.
Here we can see them enjoying the new corner, the living terrace inside the living room. The sun is coming from the south of the building, and it's something very simple for them, because when it's winter time, they can close completely the living room and they can film the whole nation of the house.
Detail research for you to see, and it's also an important part when you sign it, and you put a lot of work in this, you just don't tell it to me. This was a very difficult thing to do. Actually, in 2006, when we started, we went to talk with these firms that there were windows, and all they said was, I think the different one was actually do it. The other one said, no, we don't have it, but maybe we could do it. So we talked to them, and during our development of the project, actually today that's quite standard. You can talk about like all the window firms, like construction firms are able to do this, but 5 years ago it was the first time. And not certainly only social housing.
It's expensive.
It's very expensive. Actually it's people who use it usually it's like luxury. These houses in the Maleka or in other places, Maleka. That's what you can do.
So it's a little bit strange for the owner that the rail is inside the living room. But this is funny because you feel really like a balcony. You are in a balcony, so our character don't. He can see to the other owners, he can see the patio. And there is a kind of relation between the different owners using this situation of the new balcony inside the living room. Here we can introduce other neighbors, they are the girls. And we can see they meet together for the first time here right now. But suddenly something happened. There are more neighbors there. So that is something is happening in our building. The core connections are also open to the living room. So you can see there are a lot of connections between the neighbors. What will happen here? We don't know.
So this is the typical floor, and as we see in the first the relations between these places are an unexpected event for us. We made this project, but we didn't know that this was going to happen so this way so rapidly. So it was also a surprise for us that you have this living room to core connection, that's a square connection, this living room to living room connection. connection. This connection, the girls were here, the dog was here. You can see those connections there. And so the relationship between the open places, the open shared places, and the open private places. This is where the housing unit is located in the Grandport plant, and by means of a rotation of 180 degrees rotations, we made the union between the two units. So we have living rooms overlooking the courtyard, and living rooms overlooking the street. And they give these gaps in between.
This is that we use it not just that, but also to put light inside and especially to get air outside. Then you can test a little window, I hope. So we have this.
So here we can see one of our characters. He's in one of the connection holes in the third. And what is funny, this is just a place where you can enjoy with the other neighbors, but it's also a place where you can relax and yourself. Because there are some spaces where you can stay alone. You can think about your life there, you can think about the real estate bubble, and think, oh, what's happening here? So, we're asking ourselves, and they all live it we think they Don and Betty, they have a new house and they want to make a party there. And they want to invite the other neighbors and do together the new building. They start a new relation between the neighbors. In Spain, we like the party. We like the late night party, so let's enjoy the party all together.
Yes. Tools we know as architects, space, connections, visuals, all those things that we can do a lot with. All the things that you can make communities grow, but we have our own tools and we try to use them as good as we could. And especially with the care we have made or worked with, all the shared spaces, maybe the thing. And what's the point during the project that I thought that maybe this project it's not so relevant. It doesn't look so new, so wow, architecture. But after when I went there and made one of the pictures, I noted that in a way what we are proposing, that the new this is Spanish living. This is not. I mean, people in Spain don't like to be exposed. So there's one thing that we're taking a risk at. We are putting people living in a new way. We are not sure if people are going to accept it or not. But we think that is maybe what is needed in these new places in the town, in new towns, where what happens sociologically is that everybody has their own flat, they have their own car, they get there, they get inside, they get out, they get to their flat, they don't meet the neighbors. So what we try to do here is in this new architecture, to get people to establish these old relationships between them, which belong to the village, which is new part.
We add that the comment, the characters are based on the commentaries posed by the new neighbors in a blog. They make blogs for like getting to know each other before they enter the building, and they put their opinions about how the construction is going on, what they think about the building, is white, is black, whatever. We use these commentaries for. Their commentaries for our characters, Don and Leon. The process of this building has been very long. We worked in it for 6 years between design and construction because of some problems and whatever. And you went to thought that this building is so
yours.
So it is yours. And there's so much time there with this. This process that is going to begin, but it's not ours. It's to be done for the future tenants and also for the city. So nothing else. If you want to pose any question, we are happy to answer. Thank you very much.
So I have one question. I'm from Bosnia, and my name is Nikola. I like space and ambience you make. I want just to ask one simple question. I think your living room is too short, that 3 meters. I don't see the space where you put, because you like to watch football and basketball, you are good in sports. I don't see any space where you can put, for example, TV or some devices, I don't know, it's not important. That's one question. What do you think, is that a space large enough to for family with 6 or 5 mm-hmm. members?
Yeah.
Because you have 3 rooms, I think.
No, there are things that are far away from our possibilities as architects. But we have worked with promoters, and promoters fix certain things.
Okay.
The number of bedrooms is fixed, and the width of the living room is fixed also by the regulations. If you go to wider, you can go to wider living room, you will get a proportion that probably is not good enough also. And you don't have the enough surface, you don't have a fixed surface, a fixed total surface. When you put bedrooms, bathrooms, living rooms, you don't have a lot of the space like for...
Yeah, actually, we like to make even...
Yeah. Okay. I understand, okay.
Yeah, that's
yeah. Okay, and what...
About the TV.
Okay.
Don't worry. You have it, please.
Okay. And one other question. I saw yesterday that you like to put fences around the new buildings. I don't know, I think that isn't your fault, like architects, than just ordinary people in that building who wants to put fences around the building. And why is that so?
Yes. There is a connection between the streets and the inner space when you have fences.
It is a visual connection. It depends, that's quite an important thing. It depends where you're working. Yeah, if you're working in the center of Madrid, maybe it's very important to make very much public space. But if you're working in Sánchez de Vallecas, where there is almost too much public space, you don't need to make more. Sometimes you don't need to make more. If you want the public space to work, you don't have to have lots of public space. You have to have the exact amount that makes it work. And there are different places, so you have to have different stretches. And where we are working, there is too much public space. So we don't need to open the actually, in there nearby, there was a building, left all the ground floor free. And
yeah.
And
you don't have free space in ground
floor.
Yeah,
but for you don't like to develop, maybe that's not always the best way to do it. Sometimes it's better to build a street, to build a shop,
And we also, we didn't mention, but we struggled to get to maintain a shop just in the corner for people to be able to buy food for wine or bread or something. You know. So the thing about actually, when I was in university in school, I was always like thinking, like I was taught that public space is always good and that's always much more. Then years after, they also taught me in another course, but I would that you have to make the exact amount that works. You don't have always to make very much. Because what happens when there is too much public space, you can see it in some ways, in some areas in the is that it's not taken care of. It doesn't have enough density, and it doesn't have enough people to take care of it, and then it's there. That is what is happening in many areas, it's just in the outer parts of the place, not here, which this is okay.
What has happened in this plot in Eco Boulevard, where the architects take the decision to open completely the factory to the street, and when the owners arrive to the building, they put the fence because they feel like they need the fence.
So why you are hard trying to make those living rooms so open when you see that people putting fences and want to have smaller windows? Why are you trying to make some Amsterdam here, some Amsterdam living rooms?
Because modern people in Spain, some of them like to live that way. Yeah. And it's not the same. It's not the same to have a big window. Because there's one quite important thing, right? Also, when you have a line here, which is, this is mine, and this is your, this is public. And I take care of this and this line, and that's maybe from a realistic world it was very nice that everybody took care of everything, but that's not what happens in reality. And as you have seen, we try to work with reality. We try to work with the things that really happen. So if one way of achieving that the street will be taken care of is putting a little line there or a little fence, sometimes it's better than just leaving it open and nobody taking care of it.
And you can imagine it. I prefer to have the opportunity to have the window. If I don't like the window, I can close the window with a curtain or whatever. But if I cannot open the window because there is a wall, for me it's worse than to have the opportunity to have it.
But I think that world is not a landscape or something. It's a neighborhood. You have a world of neighborhood. Open road to a neighborhood, not a mountain, you know, not some sea or something.
Yeah, that would be better.
There is big living room, you know, window to.
Yeah, that happened a lot in Holland. You are open to the neighborhood, but the people doesn't look inside your house because.
And there's another thing called natural surveillance, which. Also talk about the security streets, and it has to do with how much people are looking outside and they are looking what happens. Just knowing that someone is looking makes a city safer. And I can imagine that people who are looking by this building will be knowing that people are looking what they are doing. Maybe one.
You mentioned the curtains. Are there any on those corners?
Curtains? We did as well, actually. We had in the competition, we had curtains on the outside. But we couldn't keep them. One side was too expensive, on the other hand, we ended up with them. We didn't want to have these two.
The maintenance of these things is they were going to worn out very easily, so they don't want this kind of devices. They want devices like this one, the persianas, because they are uglier, but they need longer.
But the windows have solar protection.
Yeah, they have a solar protection. So.
But we really realized that to put the curtain we like, it will be worse for the building that leave the people put the curtain they want, because I think that the building will be much better when the colors of the different coatings began to give the life to the building.
Thank you.